There we go. Internet. It's a thing. Alright, let's get my controller turned on here. I might have to restart my emulator for this to... Yeah, it's not gonna pick it up. For whatever reason, you gotta restart the emulator. Why? I don't know. Let's load the game. There we go. Okay. Hey, Billy. Welcome. Fucking Twitch's automod got you for that one. Apparently the term thoughts is offensive to Twitch. Fucking DuckTales. So good. And hey, Astro Monkey, good to see ya. Hope you've been doing well. I did get your email. I apologize for not having replied to it. I got a late start today. What is it, Peaches? Is it a DuckTales image? Oh my god, there is a DuckTales image! Jesus Christ! What?! Oh. Eh, there we go. Wrong scene. That's why the screen was all fuckered. Because I was in the NES scene and not the Super Nintendo, because I'm so, like, convinced that Dragon Quest is a Nintendo game. Also, the chat's not on the screen. I can literally see the chat in my preview window. That might just be the delay, though. Yeah, like, my internet is half shitting the bed, but it seems to be getting better. Ideally, it will be okay. So I think we have to go... I think last time we got, like, the mark of Lodo or whatever. It still pisses me off that they call him Roto. There's... yes, we have the token. Alright. And somebody had mentioned in the comments that, like, yeah, that's, like... Japanese doesn't have L's, so they use R's, and like, I get that. That's something that I've known since like the 90s, old anime and all that. But Dragon Quest has never called him Roto. That's just some translator tarding out on things. I don't get it. DuckTales is a fucking great game, though. I'm tempted to play it again. It's like a nice, quick, short jaunt, and I would. But we did it, like, what, last month? Oh, man. Don't worry about it, Astro. There is absolutely no rush. Absolutely, absolutely no rush. You work at your own pace. What is this life? I don't know, but it's going south real goddamn fast, I can tell you that. Ghost on ghost crime. Some hot ghost on ghost action. Yeah, if ghost kills ghost, nothing of value is lost. There used to be druids in this cave. I remember things from old Dragon Warrior. I don't even know if they're in here anymore. Are they? No, we have scorpions instead. You can, in fact, give Gene feedback. Man, I fucking feel ya. I'd be streaming more, but... Fucking... Man, COVID has fucked... my shipping job up so bad.
Fresh meat.
It's terrible. Hey, thank you, Billy. I appreciate that. Good to see that my bot bullshit actually works, too. I haven't had a chance to test it in live. You're awesome. Thank you very much. I've got, like... this sob story got you. Man, it's so hard. It's so hard. Streaming is so hard. I have to put in so much effort to find 4 hours a week to play video games for people on the internet. As I punch my microphone.
Oh no! Mormons!
You would think that our job would be less busy with supply shortages, and for a while it was. Fucking microphone. There we go. For a while it was, Then one of our facilities, like, all right. So the way it works is, I mean, we have hubs throughout the country. And our hub is one of a handful of air hubs. So we handle, like, plane transport and stuff. And normally that's not a big deal, and the volume is reasonable, barring, like, peak time. But one of our nearby hubs burnt to the ground. So, like, we're basically doing, like, a hub and a half's worth of work now. So, top that up with, like, nobody wanting to work there because the pay is shit until you hit, like, seniority, and it's a challenge. Apple Kino announced they were trying to bring gaming to Mac. Resident Evil Village. Divinity Original Sin 2. Damn. Yeah. Yeah, exactly. Like our nearest competitor pays... Our nearest competitor pays, I think, $21 an hour as a part-time, like, new hire. We pay $15 an hour, and after 6 months, you get benefits. And to be fair, the benefits are fucking excellent. I have the best health insurance now I have ever had in my life. Like, my yearly deductible, and I am not misspeaking, my yearly deductible is $100. You do not get that in the United States, but we do. But the pay is absolute shit. I've been there for almost 10 years now, and because of how they've been giving, like, huge raises for cost of living, I make, like, a dollar more than a new hire does an hour. It's ridiculous. But we have union negotiations coming up, and the new union president we have fucking hates the place. So hopefully we'll be getting a good pay bump. Descendant of the great hero Rodo, now is the time when rain and sun will join. Give me the staff of rain and the stones of sunlight. Okay, we do that. Oh gods, I offer rain and sun to this holy altar. Unions, that communist stuff? Yeah, I know, right? That stuff that got us weekends and all that fun stuff. Now approach the altar and take the rainbow drop. Take it. Do I have to search? What? You found the rainbow drop! It was sitting there out in the open and everything. Alright. Fuck you, old man, you were a pain in the ass. Sunday was always a non-work day. Yeah, but unions got a Saturday and not having to work, like, 16-hour shifts. That's what, like, always blows my mind about people in the States that are like, oh, unions are dumb. Like, tell me you don't know what unions have done for the working class without telling me you don't know what unions have done for the working class. Oh my god, all these gold men. I have no need for your money, and now you're everywhere. Like, we need experience. We're probably gonna have to do some leveling, unless they made the end game here a lot easier. Which I kind of doubt that they did. Unions haven't done enough for the working class, at least in the UK. Yeah, I can't speak to you guys. I just know what they've done for us over here. And what they've done for us over here is basically given the working class quality of life, essentially. Their joke outside the rail industry. That's a shame. Like, that's just legit sad to hear. Man, y'all remember when this area was dangerous? And I was, like, shivering on our way 3 steps out of town, and then I had to run back in because a monster hit me? And now we're just, like, walking through the landscape and things jump out at us and we're just like, no. Alright. Give me that rainbow bridge. Use. Ghost, raise the rainbow drop toward the sky. Hey, thank you for the follow. I appreciate it. Top shelf. All right. I think we get dragons back here. I think we can fight dragons back here. Ah! Skeleton sound effects coming in for the kill. I don't know what you're talking about, Celt. I've never saved scummed in my life. We've only saved this game like once. I don't know what you're talking about. This is my single save playthrough. What you're talking about. So we're at 100. How? Oh, all right, I gotta get into a fight here, cause like I know the armor of Lodo heals you, but I thought it was like a hit point a step. I think it's way more than a hit point a step. I'm gonna let something beat on me and see what it actually does. He doesn't have a defend option. I guess I don't know why it would, but uh-oh. Okay, we're good. Alright, so let's see what taking a step does for our health here. 85. 86. Oh, okay, I see what it is. So it is a step, but they have the squares in this one. Its squares are separated, like one square is two squares, because you take half steps in this one for whatever fucking reason. So it makes it heal much faster than I initially thought it did. Okay. Okay, we got dragons. The last one of these we fought wasn't exactly a challenge, so I don't really expect these guys, yeah, to be too much of one either. I mean, shit, if it heals us that much, this is gonna be pretty potent. It's pleasing to me. Can I open the door? Yes. I think we can walk on this and it won't hurt us now? Yeah. We do want light, though. I don't remember this dungeon at all. Like, the others I had, you know, mild inklings towards, like, where to go. This one, not so much. I got my thermal footsies. Nobody can hurt me now. Our only limiting factor is our mana pool. And for that, really, what do I cast anymore? And this Star Chimera. It's refusing to go down. Damn, that was a chonky lad. We do have spells to escape if need be, although the walk back is not something that I'm really too excited about. Kingmaker was so good! Kingmaker was so good. I streamed an entire playthrough of that game. So good. It's like 90 hours. It was so good until like the house at the end of time. Then it went from like game of the year to a solid 3 out of 5. Yes. The last part of Kingmaker fucking sucked. But I think that might be better if playing it with turn-based mode. Doing it real-time with pause was like 90. It wasn't 60 hours. It was maybe like 2 or 3 streams. So like between 8 and 12. It was rough though at the end. Real rough. But up to that point, I had a really good time with it. I'm looking forward to the Wrath of the Righteous. We'll probably be doing that one next year, if I had to guess. That'll be the big RPG for next year. Because when we're done with this, starting next week, so Saturday the 2nd, we're going to be jumping back into Baldur's Gate 2. So that'll be an adventure. Wrath of the Righteous, to my understanding, is even longer than Kingmaker, but it's a little bit more linear, so if that's like your jam, might be worth doing, I don't know. But I've played the intro portion of Wrath of the Righteous, and it was pretty good. Hard to understand where you can go, and where you should probably reload and go somewhere else. I mean, yeah. Like, that's kind of a problem with, open-world games in a nutshell, though, is, like, if they don't give you, like, a really strong, go here, do this, like, it's easy to kind of be, like, aimlessly wandering forever, and you just kind of lose desire to keep pushing. Pick up Kingmaker for free? Hell, that's a good deal, then. If I recall correctly, they told us that there was a secret behind this throne. Yeah. And this is the actual way we're supposed to go. I think this place is like 6 levels deep or something. Is this a thing right here? No. But yeah, Kingmaker's pretty good. And it's got like mods and stuff for it now too. So you've got all that stuff to go with that add like new classes and stuff. I think it was the mod that added the Oracle. I think they actually like contacted the mod maker or something and used his stuff for Wrath of the Righteous. I may be talking out my ass on that, but I seem to recall reading something to that effect. How to fight a mana core outside the tutorial. I was like, yeah. Oh man, Astro. The random overland encounters in that game. They can be just absolute nutbusters. That's not necessarily you being in the wrong place. That's just RNG murdering you. It used to be so much worse. So much worse. But yes, it can be pretty bad. And like, they don't really let you run like you'd be able to with most DMs in tabletop. Playing the one that they gave for free on Epic because you're a broken game dev. Hey, you know, that's... You're playing the same game I played. First encounter you got was Skeletal Champions. The only really nasty overland encounter that I remember getting was that, like, group of Elder Fire Elementals when my party was, like, third level or whatever. And then they patched it out, and it would have probably been something a little bit more reasonable. Yeah, exactly. Those fucking fire elementals just bodying me. Yeah, like, they have the same problem with, like, traps and stuff that the gold button, not gold box games, Infinity Engine games like Boulder's Gate do, where a lot of it, a Kith Dragon, I'm gonna actually heal myself, where it's like, if you don't know it's coming, you're gonna die. But once you know it's coming, it's not a big deal. Don't you be judging dragons based on their size. They have huge personality, okay? Rude. Yeah, this place is like 6 levels deep, and the music just keeps going like lower and lower the deeper we get. I think, oh my god, those weir rats! That one cave! It's got like, and not only are they weir rats, they're weir rats with rogue levels. So they just swarm your damn party and then like sneak attack the shit out of you. Oh. Kith the dragon. Oh god, now Kith. One thing that I would suggest, Astro, is like difficulty settings with regards to Kingmaker. I played through, like, I am somebody that is pretty mechanically solid when it comes to, like, Pathfinder. Like, I know what I'm doing when it comes to character building. I played the game on, like, core difficulty or whatever until the very end, and then I had to turn it down to easy. So I wouldn't feel too bad about turning down difficulty settings, if I'm being honest. Like, some of the monsters in that game are so fucking overtuned, like, that you would never be facing in actual tabletop. You shouldn't feel bad about turning down the difficulty at all. They fixed the house at the end of time? Uh-huh. I'm not gonna put another 80 hours into that game to see what they did to the house at the end of time. Too little, too late. Disabled crits. Yeah, there you go. Nowhere near as bullshit. I mean, that would be nice. Man, sneak attacks in Pathfinder are, like, in Kingmaker are so much better than they are in tabletop. They're actually worthwhile. If tabletop crit sneak attacks were like that, rogues would actually be useful in combat. Yeah, like... That's like, I'm curious what they were balancing for with some of those critters. Like, I think I get what they were going for, because, like, a lot of the times when they did that with stuff, it was where it was like a whole party fighting one monster. But like, that's not something you can fix by just like hyper overtuning a monster's stats. Like, Pathfinder just doesn't work in fights like that. You just don't do fights like that in Pathfinder. But they did. They did. I assume we're on the right path. If I recall correctly, we have to go down and then we, like, loop back up. I also recall the Dragonlord being a multi-phase boss fight. No, because you fight him as, like, a wizard and then you fight him as a dragon, I think. It wouldn't be Dragon Quest if it weren't multi-phase boss fights. I should stream a playthrough of Dragon Quest XI. I fucking love that game. Oh my god, that I totally forgot about that dude. Yeah, the one tribal leader. That dude was fucking mean. The one that I always remember is that fucking troll you fight early on. It's like the second dude, like the second boss guy you fight. And I mean, Vordekai was a tough fight, but that's only because he spams like a bullshit spell that at minimum does like 70 damage to whoever it hits. Well, hello there, chamber full of tentative loot. A cursed belt. Wing of Chimera. Our inventory is now probably full. No, I don't remember. It wasn't Finger of Death, it was like, Bone Shiver or whatever. All I knew is that he could hit Cambly with it, like, twice. And it would kill him if he hit him with it a third time. We did not die there. We have yet to die playing this game. We're too good at video games to die here. I don't think we need that treasure room, though. As far as Act 2 with a mixed fighting ranger, now you've restarted a sword and board. Can work. I played, I was a sword and board fighter cleric multi-class in my playthrough, and it worked pretty good. Alright, so these Hades Knights are no joke. I might actually have to heal myself here. Firebane. Oh, they can heal more too. So what I'm hearing is that these are fights that maybe we should just avoid. I have to let's play it to finish it, oh man. It gets pretty rough towards the end, I will say that. Like, well, it got pretty rough. I think, I want to say that it is one of the only games, if not Darth Dragon, we have a Sith Lord Dragon. I want to say it is maybe one of the only games that I've ever played that got me to rage quit it on stream. The shit with the, Wild Hunt was so bad that I had to, like, I just had to stop. I wonder what the Dragonlord thinks of the hero just, like, pacing back and forth in front of him to regenerate his health before he comes in to fight him. You have come, ghost! I am the King of Kings! I am King Dragon! Another, like, random stupid name. I've been waiting for you, so the young man destined to arrive. If you want to be my ally, I'll give you half the world. What do you say? Won't you be my ally? No. What? You don't want half the world? Disappointing. Would you like to reconsider? No. Well then, by all means, try to defeat me. Foolish mortal, you will realize what true suffering is. Alright. King Dragon sends his regards. Fucking... Pro ZD. What are you wearing? This is my ass-kicking outfit, bitch! Man... enemies being able to heal themselves isn't fair. Uh-oh. Ow, okay. Fucker hitting me with sleep. Can I stop spell him? No! This is JRPG! Only the enemies get to use status effects to any effective, like, effect, I guess. I don't know. I hate that about JRPGs. Oh, we're dead. I mean, we're totally fine and that never seriously, fuck you, game. What items do we have? I'd say, oh, maybe we should have some healing items, but the only healing items in this game are garbage, so it doesn't really matter. The hairstyle, he's like full Rita Repulsa. No. Yeah, foolish mortal, rabble rabble, true suffering. Okay. We need to like stop spell this guy. I'm gonna just spam it and see if we can make it stick. Man! And this is something that Dragon Quest does. Like, they all do this. Where your spells just... you might as well never try doing anything to a boss that isn't damage. I hate it. Alright. We may need to do some level grinding. We very well may. Cause like fireball isn't gonna be enough to do anything to him. Not Phantasy Star, but an RPG for the Master System. I have no idea. See, like, that he cast Heal More leads me to believe that I should stop spell him. So I know Heal More heals for probably all the damage that I'm doing to him. But I can't. And if he sleeps us, due to how sleep works, like, can't really do too much. Maybe we should just sit here and grind out some levels. Yeah, the ISP is just flat dead. Stream is just flat dead. Man. Fucking hate everything. Just fucking hate everything. Try to stream now. Rise from your grave. I don't even want to know. Like, we were good until we weren't. Are we back up and running? I highly doubt it. Like, OBS is still saying that the internet is shitting the bed, and I have no reason to disbelieve that. It might be, like, leveling out, but... yeah. Hey, Pinky, it's good to see ya. Glad to be here. Should ISP doing what Should ISP does. We don't get good things on this Friday. This Friday is a dark day. It's trying. It is trying, but is not happy. I need to get like an overlay of what my network upload looks like so y'all can see just how terrible it is. It's rough. Oh, man. I don't know. Maybe it's like the... Because, like, this is about the time of year that it fucked off last year, too, wasn't it? When my internet just decided it wasn't going to let me do anything on it anymore? I don't fucking know. How far are we? Well, the final boss is standing right up there. We just have to grind levels so that we can actually beat him. We're at the very end of the game. And once we're done with this, I was going to try to stream DDO, but with the internet being what it is, I don't think we're going to be able to stream DDO. So yeah, we'll see. We'll see if it unfucks itself. I don't know. There's level 18. I think we get Firebane at level 20. The annual pet hamster feeding. Nah, the internet's been like, it's been bad for the last week or two. I don't know what the issue is. Unless it's the heat. But I have no idea. Is the final boss level cap or bust? In the original, I know you had to be, like, fucking high level to beat him. I don't know what it's gonna be like in this. They've really retuned things. Yeah, this is my internet in a nutshell. Here, let me, like... Do this. Alright, what is this gonna be? This is gonna be, network. I'm gonna show you guys what my ISP, like, is actually looking like right now. This one? Yes. Okay. It's not control. Alt, there we go. Do that. There. So now you all can see what my network is doing. Upload is on the right. If it's working properly, that's a straight line. You can see exactly. The only time it's been a straight line today has been when it crashed. And to be uploading at a stable frame rate, we need to be at 300 kb a second. So you can see that it's going at, like, you know, 60. Because video games. I should probably not show my external IP address, but I guess it doesn't really matter. It shuffles so often. Now I probably should get that off of there. Because while you guys are chill, there are assholes on the internet. There we go. Hey, Queen Cinder, welcome! Good to see ya. Hope you're doing well. Sorry for what is in store. I'd try to restart the internet, but I don't think it would help. But yeah, this may be a short stream. We may just grind out these levels here, beat the Dragonlord, and call it there. Speeds are giving me flashbacks to college. Yeah, this is like giving me flashbacks to living back in Indiana again. It's pretty rough. Keep in mind, of course, that I'm paying $120 a month for this. Feels good, man. At least the grind is pretty straightforward here. It flatlined? Yeah, basically. We're gonna push through this. I'm not giving up. We are going to beat Dragon Quest because we have to start Baldur's Gate next week. We have to. Exactly. Are we back? Ha ha ha! I don't know, I doubt it. We'll see. We'll see. OBS still says no. It's like, look at that. It's like, God almighty, I hate this fucking internet ISP so much. Oh! Just pure rage. That's the first time we've actually had to heal. Yeah, no kidding, right? Grinding and buffering, man, that's what we're here for. What we're here for. And I don't know if it's just Twitch or what. But, yeah, it's rough. Here on that for fiber. Yeah, no. Sadly, I don't live in an area that gets fiber, and because this is the United States, our ISPs have no competition, so we get shit in the mouth and we get to like it. Good old capitalism doing what capitalism does. Yeah. Unregulated capitalism turning this country into a shit pile from inception. I don't know how high we're gonna have to grind. I don't even know. I think in the original the level cap was 30. I wonder if they brought... There's no way we're grinding to level 30. Like, that would be asinine. We might... Maybe we'll aim for 20. Oh, man. Rent here? Like, the cheapest apartments locally for a one-bedroom here is, like, $1,200 a month. Like, it is very expensive. Very, very expensive to live here. We heal in yourself, Hades Knight, only I may do that. We'll save before we attack here, just in case it kills us. It did not. Never a doubt in my mind. I should probably heal, but I won't. Like, the thing that really gets me with apartments is, like, it's like, okay, $1,200 a month, but if you want to actually be able to rent this place, you need to be, like, your take-home needs to be four times that. And it's like, fucker, if my take-home was four times that, I wouldn't be renting your little shitbox apartment. But that's not how it works. Today's stream is just a bad time. It's just a fucking bad time all around. Yeah, the internet's been shitting the bed for like 20 minutes now. And I would swap where I'm connected to on Twitch, but I know it's not gonna help. Like here. Let's do this, let's do this, come in here, stream.